Here's a question I want you to think about and reflect on. And the question is, since our sensory processing seems to be quantum in nature, eyes can detect a single photon. And so we also know that olfaction is quantum in nature. We know that touch is quantum in nature. It's becoming obvious that quantum processing is how our senses operate. So, if our sensory processing is quantum in nature, then is it possible that our current science, which says that our senses actually take in information from a so-called external world, maybe that is not the right paradigm. Is it possible that we do not actually perceive an external world, that our thinking, that our senses perceive a world that's already there, is probably the wrong paradigm, and even though science is based on it. So it's possible that we do not perceive an external world. It's actually more likely that we project an external world that includes our body and mind. The we is not body mind, the we is consciousness. Now, of course, quantum mechanics is a probabilistic theory, which means that it does not predict the exact outcome of any event. This means that our perception of the world could be influenced by quantum unpredictability. Scientists call that quantum randomness, but I don't like the word randomness, which means everything is inherently random. Unpredictable is a good word. It means we don't know what's going on, but whatever is going on is creating the universe. So, using this argument, we can look at several possibilities that one of these possibilities is that quantum consciousness is projecting a species-specific experience as its own perceptual activity. In other words, you and I are projecting that world. That means that our consciousness is creating our reality rather than simply perceiving an external world. It is creating the experience of an external world, but there is no external world. The whole thing is happening in consciousness. So there are lots of possibilities that have been raised by the study of quantum mechanics. This field, of course, is in its early stages. And as scientists always say, there's more research needed, more understanding of quantum mechanics and its relationship to what we call consciousness. Here are some arguments that favor what I'm suggesting. Quantum mechanics is a fundamental theory of nature, and it is possible that consciousness is that fundamental property of nature that uses quantum technology to create the experience of the universe and the body mind. Quantum mechanics is probabilistic, which means that it does not predict the exact outcome of an event. And this could allow for a degree of freedom in our consciousness, such as the ability to make choices. Also, quantum entanglement allows for objects to be linked together in a way that cannot be explained by classical physics. And this could be a mechanism for showing consciousness to connect to the physical world. Because the physical world is quantum in nature, and mind is quantum in nature. Consciousness is quantum in nature. mind modified form of consciousness. So let's look at some very simple principles. Before a particle appears as an object, before it appears, that particle is entangled with all other particles in superposition. And the same thing is true of thought. Before you have a thought, it is in the field of possibilities, entangled with all other thoughts. Okay, so that's number one principle that shows the correspondence between a thought and a particle. The second is that the appearance of the particle is determined by what we call the uncertainty principle. And the same applies to thoughts. Our thoughts are surface in our consciousness as determined by the uncertainty principle. Number three, particles take quantum leaps. They move from one location to another without going through this space in between. Our thoughts can do the same. So think of your mother, and now think of the Empire State Building, and you move from one location to another without going through the space in between. So that is another aspect. The fourth principle here is, in order to understand wave-particle duality, you have to actually bring your attention and intention to an experiment. And you have to create that experiment. Incidentally, that's how perception occurs. You have to bring your attention, your awareness, and intention to what you want to perceive. You know, it's not just passive stuff coming into you. We can direct our sensory apparatus to what we want to experience. All these arguments support quantum mind as an expression of quantum consciousness. But of course, that is species specific. And in our case, it's culture specific, in that, you know, we see through the culturally, socially, economically, historically, scientifically conditioned mind. So we never experience truth. We are the truth that projects the reality that we call body, mind, and universe. So I think science needs a revision. We do not perceive an external world. We project it. And that external world includes our body, mind, intellect, and ego. Let me know what you think.